Sarah from West Kara Pacific Islands about the very, very sensitive and very necessary topic of taking care of our vets and providing wellness for those who served before. Half a day to you both. Happy Liberation. Good to see you.
Buenas. Buenas.
Now, I've known the both of you for years. You both have had a multitude of responsibilities for the island, civic service and everything like that. But, John, is there any concern possibly any more noble than want to take care of those who put themselves in the line of fire for our liberties before?
Well, thank you, Jason. That's a very good question. So for almost 30 years, I almost did the same thing with the government of Guam, providing services or coordinating services. The opportunity I have now, which I really appreciate with WestCare, is that I actually have an opportunity to work directly with veterans who are either experiencing literal homelessness or being at risk of homelessness. So, you know, there's a great feeling in making that all work and seeing our veterans get the services that they rightly deserve.
And it's remarkable, Sarah, because I know, I mean, any vet could be someone who is just fresh out of the military. There may be somebody in their 20s who may have served before. Mm-hmm. You know, they did a certain number of years, and maybe someone that retired from the military or someone who's kind of like in midlife and everything. But regardless of when you served in the military, by nature of your work, you were at peak fitness like the whole time, and now you've got to take care of, you know, mental health, physical health, even spiritual health, correct?
Absolutely, absolutely. And of course, your social health, your That's willingness and interest in, socializing and being involved in your community and in your family. And, you know, on Guam, that's really big for us, you know, is to be involved in our family. And it's very painful when you see a member of your family who just stays in the room or wants to be left out in our, what we call our ranch, or just outside of their house for hours and hours by themselves.
Just staring off into the horizon,
and just kind of
contemplating.
Yeah, right.
I've seen that a bunch.
Yeah, and like you said, you know, they oftentimes join the military when they're, 19, 20, you know, young. And they come back after maybe 3, 5, 20, 30 years, and they're forever changed. You know, they're just very different, and they're both men and women. And they don't have the same interests, and their personality might have changed quite a bit. And so, one of the things that we do at West Kara Pacific Islands is see what we can do to re-engage veterans with their community, with their family, and to take a look at what their overall needs are. And you mentioned them very well. Their mental, emotional, physical and spiritual, social health. You
know? The spiritual one, John, is something I'm really curious about, because how do you actually approach, you know, the nature of faith with someone who, I mean, because for a lot of soldiers and seamen, Marines, airmen, what have you, and everything, their faith is actually what got them through the nature of their duty. And for others, right, they're kind of getting back into, you know, reading the Bible, recommitting themselves to a higher power, because when they were in the military, it's like, hey, you may have to go overseas and do some really, really nasty things in service of your country.
Yeah, so again, the spiritual aspects of a veteran's, or everybody else's well-being is actually part of our role as veteran advocates and case management in our SSVF program. Because while we're going through the intake process or even speaking with the veteran, one of the questions is that, you know, what is it that gets you through during your hard times, your times of struggle, your times of hardship? And 9 times out of 10, that veteran is going to respond that, you know, I turn to my faith, I turn to my, you know, to my priest, I read the Bible. It's very, it's spiritual in nature. So, you know, spiritual wellness is a big part of not just our veterans' lives, but everybody else's life.
Mm-hmm. How many veterans, Sarah, are you working with right now?
Well, since we started our supportive services for veteran families about 4 years ago, we have way over 400 veterans, both male and female, who we've worked with to prevent homelessness. The whole thrust of this particular program that West Kara Pacific Islands has with the Veterans Administration is to prevent our veterans from being literally homeless, which means out in the streets, with no place, no suitable housing, or those who are at risk of homelessness, they might have a place to be in, but there's something that's going on in their lives that are putting them in a situation where they can be out in the streets very soon, mm-hmm. without a support or intervention. So that's the group that we deal with. And as John was saying, it's the group that we're most concerned about, because they are veterans. They are people who have served our island, served our country, and now, because of their experiences in the military, find it very difficult to regain some semblance of normalcy in their lives. You know, go back to work, go back to school, or be active and participatory in their family. So those are the veterans that we seek out and do everything we can in a very coordinated and efficient manner with all of our service providers and veteran advocates on island. We do our best to embrace them and find out what it is that we can do to support them. Mm-hmm. If it be our friends and partners at Department of Labor, Public Health, or Guam Behavioral Health, or our nonprofit partners at Catholic Social Services, or, you know, Gumamami, or wherever, you know, we come together on a regular basis to determine, you know, what is the best support system for not only the veteran, but their family too, because it's hard for them to be strong if they don't have a strong family backing.
Very true. Yeah. And all who served are very lucky to have you and your staff having their backs. And we want to make sure to let everybody know, check out our